Today I'm starting my lecture on Chapter 5, Volcanoes and Volcanic Hazards. This is lecture number 1. Magma is a term used to describe molten rock that contains some crystals and various amounts of dissolved gases. When magma reaches the Earth's surface, for instance, out of a volcano, we refer to that material as lava. What determines the behavior of magma? One factor is temperature. Composition is another, and the amount of dissolved gases in the magma. Temperature, composition, and dissolved gases control the viscosity of a magma, which is very important in determining how an eruption will occur. That is, will it be a violent volcanic eruption? Or will it simply be a quiet, non-violent eruption? This is a pyroclastic flow coming down the side of a volcano that has erupted. These are very dangerous volcanic eruptions that include hot ash, hot gases, and other sized particles as well, and they will incinerate whatever they come in contact with. Viscosity, the term I used on the previous page, is defined as a measure of a material's resistance to flow. For example, hot syrup would be non-viscous compared to cold syrup. And the more viscous the material, the greater its resistance to flow would be. The factors affecting viscosity include temperature. Hotter magmas tend to be less viscous, as well as composition. Higher silica contents create a viscous lava. Another factor affecting the viscosity of a magma includes the amount of dissolved gases. Remember, water vapor is the primary dissolved gas in magma, and it reduces the viscosity. As magma nears the Earth's surface, the gases will expand because of lower pressure. The violence of an eruption then is related to how easily the gases can escape from magma. A non-viscous magma, the gases are easily able to escape, whereas a viscous material, the gases get trapped, build up pressure until they violently explode. This table on the bottom lists their composition of magmas, mafic, intermediate, and felsic, their silica contents, higher silica means more viscosity, gas contents, the eruptive temperatures, the viscosities, higher silica means higher viscosity, and the tendency to form pyroclastics, those very dangerous volcanic eruptions. Looking at a couple examples of volcanic eruptions, here we have a very fluid, non-viscous basaltic magma that is erupting quite quietly. In this situation, we have a viscous lava, and it has violently erupted and produced a pyroclastic flow. Not surprising, approximately 90% of lava is basaltic in composition due to the fact that our planet is 70% ocean, and basalt makes up ocean floors. Less than 10% of lava is andesitic, and even less than that is rhyolitic in composition. In looking at basaltic lava flows, there are two types, one a-a and the other pohoihoi. The difference between an a-a and pohoihoi flow is essentially their texture. A-as have very rough, jagged blocks, whereas pohoihoi flows tend to be a smoother surface resembling a twisted braid. Here is the Aa flow. Here's Pahoehoe. And here it is exhibiting, the Pahoehoe is exhibiting the ropey nature of an in appearance. Lava tubes form commonly in basaltic lava eruptions. They are cave-like tunnels and actually form in Pahoehoe flows oftentimes. And they are previous conduits that the lava escaped from. Here this person is standing in a lava tube. It is cave-like in appearance and used to carry lava from an active vent to the flow's leading edge. Here's another view of a lava tube where lava is actively flowing through. Additional materials that extrude from a volcano include block lavas. They are associated with intermediate and felsic lavas rather than basaltic. They form short flows and they have massive detached blocks. Pillow lavas is another type of material extruded during a volcanic eruption. And when we see pillow lavas, our interpretation is that they formed underwater. Here's an image of a pillow lava. As the lava extrudes, the outside portion gets chilled, and then the inside expands and breaks through, forming pillows. Gases, what we call volatiles, which are dissolved gases, are another material extruded during a volcanic eruption, making up 1 to 6% of the total weight of the magma. As the magma nears the Earth's surface, pressure decreases and the gases come out of solution. The composition of gases is primarily water vapor, 70%. Other materials erupted during a volcanic eruption previously discussed include pyroclastic materials. These particles range in size from very fine dust to sand-size ash to very large rocks. Tephra is a term used to, that is essentially the same as what pyroclastic materials, sometimes it is called tephra. The types of tephra include ash, which are fine glassy fragments, lapilli are a little larger in walnut size, cinders are pea size, blocks are hardened or cooled lava greater than 2.5 inches in diameter, and bombs are also the larger type of particle. However, they are ejected as molten or semi-molten material and tend to take on a streamlined shape because of their molten, semi-molten state. Here are examples of ash, lapilli, bombs, and blocks. This is pyroclastic material, also called tephra. Pumice is a pyroclastic material, light gray, very porous, will float in water, and tends to be intermediate and felsic in composition. Scoria is a vesicular rock, having the mafic or basaltic composition, and it is pea to basketball size in as far as fragment size goes. Let's talk about the anatomy of a volcano. A fissure is simply a crack in the Earth's crust where magma moves toward the surface. The conduit is a somewhat circular pathway from the fissure to the Earth's surface. Vent is the surface opening of the conduit. And then the volcanic cone is the structure created by volcanic eruptions of lava and pyroclastic materials. Here's a diagram showing the various features. Additional features of volcanoes are the crater, that's the funnel-shaped depression at the top of most volcanic cones. If that crater is greater than 1 kilometer in diameter, we call it a caldera, and that is produced by a collapse following an eruption. We have parasitic cones, which are located on the flanks of a volcano that emit lava and pyroclastics. And fumaroles are flank vents as well, but emit only gases. Here is a parasitic cone on the flank of this volcano. I'm going to stop at this point. This ends video 1 for chapter 5. The next video, we will discuss the different types of volcanoes: shield, cinder cones, and stratovolcanoes.